Right now, we're all in the age of AI and machine learning, where AI and these machine learning platforms are taking over the world, basically. They can help us with everyday tasks, detect water leaks, and so much more, all using AI. But you may not know that AI actually uses up water. What does technology and these computers and artificial intelligence have to do with our world's water resources? And how are these things connected? Well, in this episode, I'm going to take you behind the science of AI and water and uncover why AI actually uses so much water and what risk this poses to our future and the conservation of our water resources. Let's get right into this episode. Let's go. Alright, first we have to understand what exactly AI or artificial intelligence is. Well, to put it in very, very simple terms, it's basically teaching a computer different things and giving it a human intelligence. And this is done through a process called machine learning, which is where computers learn through trial and error and the resources that they're given. And they are able to develop this kind of human intelligence-like characteristics, and that's how these AI models and platforms exist right now. That's how they're able to do so much and basically act human. You can kind of talk to these chatbots and these models and they'll respond back to you with their answers. So that's basically what AI is. Now, to do all this, it requires a lot of processing power. And this is done using computers, very, very powerful computers. In fact, entire warehouses filled with computers. These are called data centers, and these are massive buildings that are just filled with computers that their only job is to process all of these topics and help the computer learn all of these things and help the machine learning models learn all these things and develop that human-like intelligence. Now, we have all of these computers running in this enclosed space. Now, if they're processing this much and this much information at these speeds, there's going to be heat that's generated. Like for me, when I edit my videos on my computer, sometimes I notice that the fan on my computer starts running. That's because all of that data that's getting fed into the computer is overheating the components and the electrical components, which means that it needs to cool itself down in order for it to work without it just exploding. So that's why fans and cooling systems exist in computers, in phones, in all of these smart devices. Now, when you have entire rooms or warehouses full of computers, that's where the challenge occurs. How do you cool all of these computers down, and how do you keep the cost as low as possible, and how do you do it efficiently so that the service isn't interrupted for the user? Well, that's where the water comes in. You see, they circulate water through all of these data centers in order to absorb that heat and cool it down using cooling towers. And there's also air conditioning systems that also use water. And basically, water is able to capture all that heat from all these computers without actually physically touching the computers, because electricity and water don't mix. It's able to get all that heat from the computer, and it's able to dissipate that into the air or into the outside of the building. And that's how these computers stay cool. And with the increasing use of AI, more of these data centers need to be built. And that means that more water needs to be used to cool all of these things down. Data centers have existed for a long time. That's how search engines and websites work. But when you build them at such a large scale, where you need all of these data centers in order to support these artificial intelligence platforms, that's where the problem occurs. And all this water is being used up because of AI and the computers that need to be cooled. And that's where scientists are working on different ways in order to cool these computers and to conserve more water. And there you have it. That is how water is tied with AI. And that's how the use of AI actually impacts the amount of water that's on Earth. And the increasing demand for water and AI poses a risk for the future. But luckily, scientists are helping with that. All right, before we go, I have something to tell you. You may have noticed that the setup that I'm recording in right now, it might be a little different from the earlier season. That's because it is my brand new setup. Welcome to Studio 2.0. Get ready for new science discoveries, science explorations, and more different interesting topics I'm going to be covering in this season. So stay tuned for that, and welcome to the studio. All right, before we go, let's review what we learned in this episode about AI and water. All right, in this episode, we learned that AI, or artificial intelligence, is basically training a computer to have human intelligence and to be able to answer questions that humans give it, and this is done through a process called machine learning. This requires lots of processing power and lots of computers that are in giant warehouses called data centers. And all of these computers in this enclosed area creates lots of heat. In order to dissipate or to absorb that heat, we use water to cool these systems down using cooling towers, and even air conditioning units. And as we use all this water, and as the demand for AI increases, the demand for water also increases when it comes to AI and computers. So that is an environmental problem that scientists are working on, and in order to fix for the future of AI. There's so much potential, and I'm really excited because we're all growing up in this age of AI. So it's really exciting to see what AI can do next. Alright, thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science, produced and hosted by me, Akshay Jayaraman, and our theme song, Listen to Music, are by Charan Ramachandran. Please visit my website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. If you have a science question you want answered on a Spectacular Science episode and get a special shout out, head over to spectacularsci.com/contact to submit your question there. You can also tag me on Instagram at spectacularscipod. That's at spectacular SCIPOD. Also, don't forget to grab your merch at shop.spectacularsci.com. All right, thank you so much for listening to this episode, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science next week. In the meantime, keep thinking about science.